Hello everyone, welcome again. John Mudani here today sharing bright brand new ideas to help you start your business. And as I keep talking to you, I hope that you are getting this and thinking about which business you want to start. Today we talk about five big business ideas again. Number one, we are talking about children. Have you thought about children? One of the good business ideas, we've got mothers. We've got working mothers who have children. They have young children. We have got single mothers that have got children. Now, one of the business you can do is kindergarten. Kindergarten and baby care, daycare centers. Good businesses that you can run, particularly for the toddlers, the very young babies. Mothers don't know what to do with their children. They want to go to work. I know there's now a law in a country like Kenya where every working organization is supposed to have a place for babies, but not every organization have got it. So one of the pieces you can think about is to begin to think of starting a kindergarten and a daycare center where mothers can bring children as they go to work. You take your child there with your bag for changing clothes, and you take their milk for the mommy, the caretakers, and you can take some of the food that the baby likes, and you leave there, and then you charge a daily rate. This is very, very important for your kid. It's one of the very important businesses. You not run out of business, and it can grow into a school, such as a daycare center, into a kindergarten, and then it can move even into a school. And this is a business that don't need much. You just need to have people who can help you care for that kid. It's a big business in America. Many, because in America there are no nannies. So a mother will either stop work or work, and they have to take their children to daycare. I've got my own sister in Canada, and this is what she does. She takes her child to daycare, and you have to pick by a certain time. So it's very important. One of the big opportunities is something about caring for babies, either starting a daycare if you love children or a kindergarten. The second business that I'm thinking about and that you should think about very seriously is about, again, and this is based on your skill, this is MC, Masters of Ceremony. Master of Ceremonies has become a big thing, and in Kenya here, they charge up to 200,000, even 300,000. The cheaper price one will charge you maybe 50. But it's a big thing that has made many people, we know them, we know some names, I don't want to say the names in this country, Kenya, but there are many who are doing that. So if you have a good voice, and you start to practice, and if you can be able to mix your voice with some jokes and entertain people, it's a laugh industry. Laugh industry is growing so much. You need to go for auditions and tests and start doing it. You can grow into it. It's not just a skill that you have, and you can really use to make money from that. And we see many people coming, whether in Kenya here or in the region. So think about your ability to be a master of ceremony, so that you can be able to MC events, parties, corporate events, national events. And when people know you're telling you, it's at very high demand. I know somebody that had to be paid $300,000 for a 2-hour event. Some people paid $50,000, some people $200,000. The other day, we paid an organization that I'm associated, we paid over 200,000 shillings for just providing 2 days of MCing service. So that's big money for you. We are talking about big money here. So think about MCing services. And if your voice is very good, you can do voiceovers and anything that you do. That's just a talent that God has given you. The third business opportunity is about cleaning services. Cleaning services. These are things you can do. How do people clean their windows? How do people clean their carpets? How do people clean their kitchen? There's very difficult, and even just beddings, curtains. It's a big business. We are all working. Moms are working. So we either, you can take your clothes to the laundry, But you need somebody to come and really, really, really comb your house. And you can combine it with something like fumigation. So I don't people have problems with cockroaches and termites, which are part of life, and ants. You can link that together. So you cleaning goes very well with fumigation services. So if you are thinking about a business, you just need to buy a small vacuum, and all this is for cleaning. It's not very big investment. And you get a few young people who don't have jobs, and you train them, and you can clean it. It can continue from cleaning a house, to cleaning offices, to cleaning cars. You know about car wash? And all these are cleaning services that you can do, and they give you a lot of money. To clean a house, you need over 10K, Kenya shillings, 10,000 plus. Cleaning a car in its full body inside out, I don't know anything, and maybe 750 to 2,000 shillings per car, and that's good money. So think about this kind of service. There's opportunity there. Cleaning windows, cleaning wardrobes, cleaning carpets, cleaning houses. This is something that you got, and offices. You can take a contract and a tender if you've got equipment and people, and clean the whole office, the whole government offices, private sector offices. People want to outsource the services because they don't have staff on their payroll. So they want to give it out. And they think about it. This opportunity is very competitive, but if you give good service, you can really get a good business there. The final business today, because today I'm talking mainly about services, the final service you can give is delivery services. These are, people have problems. How do you take things from here to there? How do you get shopping? You want to buy a flower. Sincerely, you want to travel to go to a florist to buy flowers. You want to take a card, a success card. You want to buy chocolates and remember somebody on their birthday. You want to get a document from here to there. You want to go and buy, to take something for repair. This is a service you can give, a delivery service, what I call petty errands. These small things. You need, if you are in this part of the world, you can get a motorcycle or a bicycle. And there are big companies that are running in this country, big organizations that are just on small time delivery. Point A to point B. Use a more flexible motorcycle, a bicycle, a tuk-tuk, and you'll be able to move from here to there. And you just need staff. And it's very labor intensive. And because of means of transport, but you can also move into public means, and you deliver. The other day I had to pay somebody 500 bob because I wanted to buy, for example, I wanted to buy a remote control, and I didn't have time to go and look for it. I didn't even know where to go and look for it because the one I had was broken. So I had to get somebody who went and got it for me and brought it, and I paid 500 shillings. And if you can do many of these, that's just me. One, I've got people who deliver for me things to offices. Go for photocopying for me this. Do take this here. Go there, bring this here. These are services that you can bring, and people will pay you. You can enter into a monthly contract if it's corporates. You can go to big companies. Hospitals always want to take documents between the hospitals and the doctor places, between the laboratory and the hospital. Those are opportunities you can do. Schools want to get things from here to there. Good hotels, they want people to do shopping for them, small shopping and deliver. So you can, if you have got such a company and you make an arrangement, you can go and buy things from a supermarket or from a supplier and deliver to a hotel or a restaurant, and then you help them to outsource that service. So delivery services is one of the great opportunities. And you can grow it into a big company. You can grow it a courier service. You grow it into the, and you can work through the internet. So this is your opportunity to help grow, start your business. This is John Mudanyi, your partner in business. And I want to remind you before I finish, please remember to subscribe. I will be producing these videos all the time. And new ideas are flowing. I feel I'm getting excited about this thing. And I'm thinking big and wide. I'm going to blow your mind with new ideas. Get prepared and get ready. But you must subscribe. Subscription is...